at 2370 Airways Boulevard. Our preliminary investigation reveals the victim is Adolph Robert Thornton Jr. This shooting is another example of the senseless gun violence that we have seen far too often locally and nationwide. Too many families, too many mothers, too many fathers have suffered in our city, and quite frankly, I think we are all tired of it. Our hearts go out to the Thornton family and all who are affected by this horrific act of violence. Tonight, we strongly encourage everyone to stay home if you do not have to be out. We also strongly encourage everyone to remain calm as we actively perform our investigation. The Memphis Police Department is providing an increased presence in areas of the city that might be directly impacted by this unfortunate incident. We are committed to working with the community to stop these senseless murders. We're also dedicated to bringing those responsible for today's shooting and others to justice. We encourage anyone who has any information about this incident to call Crime Stoppers at 901-528-2274. Let me say that again, 901-528-2274. And now I'll take a few questions.
Chief, should there be a curfew put in place? You had at least one city council member and one state representative call for a curfew, fearing that there could be retaliation. Do you think that's a good idea?
Well, we're taking all of these requests into consideration, and we're continuing to communicate with our city officials and evaluate the situation so that we can make the best decision. And it doesn't mean that we won't have a curfew at some point in time, but right now we think that the deployment of our officers in the specific areas that are impacted the most will be enough presence for tonight. And as I said before, we are encouraging everyone to stay in if they don't have to be out.
Have you had any incidents or shootings that you might think are related to what happened today with the young adult?
Well, we have investigations that are going on right now, and the Memphis Police Department, along with our federal partners, will look at every investigation and every piece of evidence to try to solve this particular case. We can't say for sure that it's associated with anything else at this time.
There have been lines circulating on social media about this shooting here, this rapper's house, this restaurant, and we understand, was any of that accurate or true?
Well, I haven't vetted all the social media. There have been erroneous posts on social media, and what we're trying to do is monitor the facts and ensure that we provide the facts to the public as well. So what we see on social media may not be accurate.
Have we been given a suspect information? I know it happened in the middle of the day.
We are still speaking with witnesses. We do have witnesses that are communicating with the police department right now.
Is there any video footage?
We don't know for sure just yet. We are checking every camera, every piece of footage that could be in the surrounding area to help us further this investigation.
You mentioned increased police presence at areas of concern. Club Privé, Yogati's Club, is that an area of concern? Is it open? Is there extra security from NPD on that scene?
Don't know if that particular location is open, but any location that might be affiliated with anyone that has a connection or we think could potentially have a connection, our officers are providing presence, and that is including the area where the shooting took place as well.
Can you say how many times he was shot?
Can't say that right now.
What can you tell us behind the motivation of the shooting?
Just don't know. This was a shooting that occurred at a cookie shop, and we're just not sure what that motivation was, and it's a little bit too early for us to tell.
Last question. Do you know if he was inside the business or outside, if he was buying cookies, visiting? There's talks that he had just delivered some turkeys during a charity. Can you just talk about what you know about his movements at that time?
Today, the victim was inside the business, and we can't say that.
Thank you.
As a crime forum chief, you talked about interveners intervening in case there is a fear of retaliation among